and to maintain my sobriety. The first one is humility, and that's part of asking for help, because you have to ask for help. You can't do this alone. You have to have faith. There's a voice. We all have that voice inside of you. If you listen closely enough, most people, if you're doing something right or if you're doing something wrong, you know inside whether you're doing right or wrong. You know that voice inside of you. You just make a choice not to listen to it. But you need to have some faith and to focus about doing right things. And some of this stuff that I'm sharing has nothing to do, has to do with drug addiction, but it also has to do with living your life and how you become successful in life. So you have to have this faith. You have to have this willingness. There's got to be a comfort. You've got to go out of your comfort zone to be willing to get help. You might, and having humility, somebody might say to you, you need help, you need to do this. You need to go, when I've been in rehab, they've told me I need to go scrub the toilet bowl. I need to do things and to have that humility to know that I'm finally going to change my life and I'm doing things differently than I did before. And the last thing that I'll leave you with, which is, for me, was the key to my recovery, and I believe it's the key to being successful in life, no matter what you do. For me, the key is persistence. It's never giving up. You don't give up. You never give up, no matter what. And that's why I am here today to talk to you, because I refuse to give up. I believe it was miraculous that I possibly have some guidance and somebody looked after me. That's my spiritual belief, but I'm not pushing any spirituality or religion or anything on anybody. For me, it was persistence. It's never, ever give up on your dream, never give up on yourself.